see that we can create classic tweens to move an object across a stage or to cycle through a track shot. There's some other effects we can do with tweening. We can also have objects grow in size or become smaller in size. We can apply different types of blends or filters to a movie clip that's being tweened, such as tinting it. And we can simulate different types of camera shots using tweens. Here I have a clip of a man with his heart. And I'm going to take the heart, and it is a movie clip object. I'm going to go to frame 20, insert a keyframe, and do the same thing on frame 40. And then on frame 20, I'm going to have that heart get a little bit larger. And let's bring the body layer in by adding a frame on that layer. And so now frame 1, frame 20, frame 1, and what I'm going to do is simply create a classic tween in between these keyframes for the heart. And let's test the animation. So you can see the object grows in size and reduces in size with those tweens. Now, let's do a couple of things with this heart. Since it is a movie clip, I can come in and maybe change the color of it. I'm going to add a tint here. Let's make the heart more green. And so now, as I test my movie, you'll see it changes in color. And let's do one more thing. Let's add a filter. And I'm just going to do a glow. Let's bring this glow up a little bit so you can see it. And now let's test this. So you see the glow also being added over the frames as well. Maybe we want the heart to become blurry. We could add a blur filter. And so it goes in focus and out of focus. All right, let's look at a couple of things we can do with tweens. I can create a panoramic shot or a pan shot using a tween. I have here an image that is much larger than the stage. In fact, I'm going to hide my image so you can see the stage. There's our stage size. The image goes way off the stage. It's much wider than the stage. But the stage really is my camera. So I'm going to come out, this is at 24 frames per second, I want to do about a 10 second shot, so I'm going to go out to about 240 frames. And I'm going to insert a keyframe. And then I'm going to take this image on that keyframe and simply move it down until it's at the right edge of the stage. And then when I have this shot linger for a few seconds, so I'll go down about 300 frames. At frame 300, I'm going to insert a frame there. And so I have these two keyframes on frames 2 and 241. Any frame in between there, I'm going to right click and choose Create Classic Tween. And now let's test the movie. And there is my pan shot. And it stops there and lingers. Same way we can do a truck in shot. So here I have a cityscape. So I'm going to do show all and show you the stage here. So it starts out here on frame 1 that my image is the size of the stage. And I'm going to have it linger for about a second and then still retain that size, but coming out a ways to frame 145, you'll see that the image has gotten much larger than my stage size. There's the stage, there's the image. And I created a motion tween in between those, or classic tween. so that as the animation progresses, I'm basically zooming in on the city. And then I'm going to have it linger there for a few seconds. Now we can also use titles or text in tweens. So I created another layer. I'm going to call this layer caption. And it has a small little text box down here. You can just zoom in on that. This is the city, March 5th, 2011. I'm going to come back out to show all. And then I created a keyframe with that same text and made it larger and set a motion or a classic tween in between those so that the text would expand in size. And then I have just sitting at that size for the duration of the clip. Let me test this and show you the effect. There's our truck in. And the caption comes up and grows. Same way we can do a truck out shot. So here I have my image starting very large. Let me show all again. I'm going to hide the image so you can see the stage size. Fairly small in comparison to the image. It's going to sit there for about a second, and then I'm going to go out a number of frames, create a keyframe, and make that image much smaller. Create a classic tween in between so that the image reduces in size. And then I'm just going to have it sit there for a few seconds. Here is the effect. So we have a truck out shot. We looked at applying color effects and filters to an animation or a classic tween. And if you're familiar with Star Trek, you know of the transporter room where the phrase "beam me up, Scotty" was popularized. And so here I have a character in the transporter room. Let me label my layers here. So we have room, we have character, and I'm going to have this character sit there for about a second and a half, so I'm going to create a keyframe here. And then over a few seconds, I want to have this character disappear. So come out to about frame 115. I'm going to insert a keyframe. And here, I'm going to take that character and I'm going to apply an alpha style to have him disappear. And after he disappears, we'll have the background of the room shot continue on for a few seconds. I'm going to insert a frame on the room layer. And now let's just test the movie. Oh, we forgot to add in our motion, our classic tween. So I'm going to go back to the character, right-click on any frame in between the two keyframes, create a classic tween. And now let's test our movie. So there he begins to disappear. Now let's sell this effect even a little bit more. I have a movie clip that I created in which I took the character, brought it into Photoshop, and added some noise. So I'm going to add another layer. This one's going to be noise. Start here at about frame 70. I'm going to insert a keyframe there. And in my library, I'm going to bring in the noise. So there's the noise symbol. I'm going to place it right on top of our character. And as the character disappears, I'm going to insert a keyframe. Out a few frames, insert another keyframe. Okay, and on this keyframe, I'm going to take that movie clip and I'm going to set the alpha back down to zero. Let's create a classic tween in between. We'll do the same thing on our first instance of that movie clip for noise. Set the alpha down to 0 and create tween. And now let's watch the effect. So it begins to disintegrate into the noise, and then the noise disappears. Might want to play around a little bit with the duration of this, adding and removing frames, but you get the idea of how we can use tweens to create this kind of cool effect. We can also use tweens to create transitions between images in a slideshow. So here I've imported 3 images. Each one is displaying for 48 frames at 12 frames per second. That's going to be 4 seconds. And you can see as I drag the playhead, there are my 3 images. And then we come to the end. Let me just play this. So a very simple slideshow. But I'm going to soften that transition between the images. So here's how I'm going to do that. I'm going to add a new layer. And in this layer, I'm going to create a square. Of just a black fill that covers the stage. I'm going to turn that into a movie clip. I'm just going to call it MC Black. Okay, and initially I'm going to come out about 6 frames, about a half a second. I'm going to insert a keyframe. On this keyframe, I'm going to select my movie clip, go to the properties, and let's set the alpha down to 0. And let's do a tween between those 2 keyframes. And a little more than a half second before the end of that image, I'm going to insert another keyframe, and then a keyframe at the end of that image. I'm going to move this one up in the alpha so that it's opaque. Let's just add another frame, add another keyframe, and then we'll go up a little more than a half second, insert a keyframe, and here I'll set the alpha back down. Okay, I'm going to create classic tweens between those. And I'm then going to select these frames, copy those frames, let's go to the next transition, and here I'm going to paste in frames. That extends my timeline down a little bit. I'm going to remove these frames. And let's do one more. This thing's going to loop. I want to, about a half second before this, insert a keyframe. Insert a keyframe at the very end. This one, I want to bring back up to it being opaque. And let's do a classic tween there. And now, let's test our movie. Fade to black transition, fade to black transition, and fade to black transition. And this will loop through those 3 images.